Residents of Patiko sub-county in Gulu trekked many miles with the police searching for their colleague who was reported missing. After hours of combing the area, a group eventually found the body of Okwera Atat dumped at a forest in a village called Marawabi. The body of the 20-year-old man is reported to have had marks that indicated he was strangled. The group carried Okwera's body to the mortuary and handed it over to his relatives from Otong village. A rumor quickly spread among Okwera village mates about the likely suspect. They accused the man, who was reportedly last seen with him, to have caused his death. The man hailed from a neighboring village. The news angered his village mates. It's reported that when night fell, over 100 community members of Atong village attacked the residents of Atak Powell village to avenge the death of their son. They torched huts and killed lots of cattle.
Where we have been supported by the government with 7 million, the 9.2 million, and we buy a piglet of 45. Then those people came here to revenge on what have happened on their sons. Then when they reach here, they destroy a lot and a lot.
The Pabo sub-county chairman, Christopher Ojera, described the attack as a cultural ritual carried out to appease the spirit of the dead person.
When our own has been killed in cold blood and you don't revenge, the spirit of the dead is going to haunt the kinsmen who are living.
The woman MP of Amuro District, Lucy Akello, urged the locals to ensure their safety by being on the lookout for strangers.
Let's come up with a bylaw that will control whoever comes in and out of Amuro in the name of timber cutting and then also charcoal burning. Because if you see the way the vehicles move in and out of this place freely.
The incident comes 3 years after a similar reprisal attack happened in Parabang Parish in Pabo, sub-county Amuro District.